Speak the name of Jesus over you. In your hurting, in your sorrow, I will ask my God to move. I speak the name cause it's all that I can do. In desperation, I'll seek heaven and pray this for you. I pray for your healing. Circumstances would change. I pray that the fear and time would leave in Jesus' name. I pray that a breakthrough would happen today. I pray miracles over your life in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Every promise he was faithful to keep. I speak the name no grave could ever hold. He is greater, he is stronger, he's the God of possible. I pray for you.
Everybody, have a seat. We're connected. Hey, isn't that song so awesome? And we chose it again for the second week in a row because there's so much healing that needs to happen, and there's so much hurt that's going on in the world. We can just list names, names, and names of people. And it's so cool to listen to that song and to truly feel His Spirit here. Last week, somebody said, hey, did you feel the Holy Spirit? I said, how could you not? Yeah, it was so good. So this week, I just want to share a couple things with our prayer list. First and foremost, thank you, everybody, for getting out of bed, getting here, and those of you joining online, thanks for choosing to worship with us. Today is going to be amazing, and I'll share with that in just a second. Those of you here, we do have the offering boxes at each side of the church. Please, if you're feeling compelled to support the ministry of the church, please do so. it makes a difference. And we know that some people are just struggling and life is difficult. But what matters is that you support it with prayers, you support it with good bread, you support it with what, however that may look like. So thank you in advance for that. I have several announcements this morning. We have announcement sheets on the chairs. Thank you. We also have them up by the announcement board. There is a sign-up sheet still that needs to be completed. Anthony's going to talk about that in a little bit. For the concession stand, again, there's a few more youth here today. If you go and work, that money that you, we help you with missions and we help you with Quake and paying for that. So it pays, literally, to go to concession stand and work that. I know John and Kelly are going up multiple weekends, so that's fantastic. right? Woohoo! This Wednesday, this is when we know fall is here. This Wednesday kicks off our small groups. So women's group, men's group, and youth group all kick off this Wednesday. 5:45, we're going to eat. 6 o'clock, we will start to watch the Global Leadership Summit videos. We chose to kick off with two of them, one from Craig Greshel and one from a gal that talks about self-worth. So it's going to be a talk about self-worth and trust. So those are the two topics that we'll be listening to on Wednesday. And then each Wednesday following, 5:45 food, 6 o'clock we start small group. So that is this Wednesday. So pretty exciting stuff with regard to that. Our prayer list this morning, this week, this thing has just like taken off and grown. So this morning, I just want to lift up lots of people in prayer. Some of you may remember Lauren Hansen. She played drums for Fish Fusion for a while. Her friend was in a motorcycle accident, and she gained her wings. So please lift up Lauren. If you knew her previously, I ask for you to reach out to her. Just let her know that you're thinking about her. I was going to meet with her today, and that's not going to work out. But please remember Lauren and her family in prayer this morning, or for many weeks. Others, we want to pray for the Heading family. There was a passing this last week, so the services are this weekend. Tennessee's cousin continuing to play for Jesse, friends and family of loved ones, and then, of course, Lauren's friend. Our cancer list, unfortunately, has grown. We don't like this. Donna Buggy, Don Hammock, Ryan Snyder, Rick Keller, Nikki Laufenberg, Jennifer Rockweiler, Richard Leeser, Joan's brother-in-law, Raylan Schnitzler, Charlie, who is an 8-year-old, that would be Dawn Stevenson's niece, Dana's sister, and I'm going to come back to that in a second. Paul Adney has skin cancer, so we're going to lift him up in prayer, Junior. Bob Lawyer, Brenda, Amy's friend, Katie Schrader, Janice Miller, Sandy Rich, Miranda Shepherd, Kay Woodkey, Jimmy Howard, Kitty Hartley, Terry, and then Misty Kohler. Is it Kohler? Keller. Misty Keller, which is Megan's friend. So that's all on the cancer list. And Misty is extremely young as well and one of Megan's close friends. So we want to lift her and her family up in prayer. I said I was going to go back. It's crazy sometimes what happens in life, but we went up for a celebration of life yesterday up north, farthest north either one of us have been. And I got to meet a gal who has stage 4 cancer. Not one type, 3 types. And this gal is fighting like no tomorrow. And her name is Terry. So we're going to be lifting up for her prayers for Terry. But then also her daughter has breast cancer, which is crazy. And then Loretta, who many of us knew, she had cancer. So it's just crazy. But their cycle and their belief was unending when we were talking to Dana, spelled Dana, but it's Dana, pretty cool. So just my whole point this morning is cherish your loved ones. Megan, Sherry, and I have kind of been talking a lot the last few days, and just cherish your loved ones because, goodness gracious, we don't know what's going on. Others that we want to lift up in prayer, injuries from accidents. Our dear Tommy Ann broke her foot. How is she doing? Is she being a good patient? Okay, all right. So he has to say that on social media. No. So we want to lift up Tommy Ann and their family. Nancy Wells, continued prayers. Kate Gilbertson, Dan McClyman, still no answers from the doctors, but he is plugging along and he is going to worship this morning. Danny's mom as well, continuing to lift her up in prayer. Carol and Dennis Witzig, Jerry's sister-in-law Sharon, Jackson's grandpa, Mackenzie, a young lady who is 31 years old, possible surgery last night for liver failure. So crazy stuff, right? And then, of course, continuing to pray for people with friends and family, just with overall health issues. Celebrations, birthdays and anniversaries. Kids went back to school, made it through the first, not even full week, as they're shaking their heads. But life is good. Education is a privilege. Don't forget that. Lots of places don't get edumacated. So, birthdays and anniversaries, of course, and then Loretta's celebration of life. And people came from all over for that. So thank you for your prayers in all of that as well. Do we have any other prayer requests? Yes. Okay, so Tilla has a great uncle who is having a celebration of life and prayers for safe travels and just for the whole celebration of life. Okay? Yes. Don Stevenson, continued prayers as well. And I know Barb's dad, we were praying for him and celebrated last week of his, how good he was doing, so continue to pray for Barb's dad as well. Any other prayers? Yes.
My friend Nicole that I used to work with at Quick Trip, her son on Wednesday ended up taking his own life. He has been dealing with mental issues all of his life. In the past few months, he's had several attempts, and she's dealing with that, and then also they had a house fire a few months ago, so it's all being compounded all at once for her.
Okay. And are they in Boscobel?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. I did not, but all right. So also Nicole, that Gary worked with, her son took his life, and then not so long ago had a house fire. So that's a lot to hold on a plate. Anyone else? Dan says for Renee Thomas, and that I would appreciate prayers. Things are tough. Things are tough. So, and I'll share just a little bit. God knows, right? And here's proof why. Anthony, sorry. This is B if you don't know by his nickname. Anthony, this week, he was going to just do, we were going to do some music, and he was going to do a brief talking, and then he sends me a message and said, my message is about 20 minutes long. It's about worship. He just laid it all out. He said, and I also have faith finders, and I have closing prayer. So he's got, like, all of it, right? And I told him this morning in my office, I said, God knows. He's so smart, you know? And we often don't think about that. We don't consider that even us, each and every single one of us, he's got us in the palm of his hand, and don't forget that. So thank you, Dan, and lots of prayers for Dan, too. All right, let's join together with our hearts, our minds, and our souls for a time of prayer. Father God, you are amazing. You go before us. You lay out the plan. Sometimes we go off the plan, and Lord, we thank you so much for U-turns, for redos, for coming back to the T in the road and going the other way. Lord, we do lift up so many people in prayer. The pain, the agony, the heartache, whether it's physical, mental, emotional, relational, financial, all of the above. Lord, we give it all to you because when we hold on to it, it just makes us super heavy. So, Lord, give us a contentment and an amazing strength to know that you got it. And like I would tell Aunt Kay every time I talk to her, let go and let God. So, Lord, that's our prayer this morning, that we, each and every one of us, let go of what's going on and just give it to God and trust in him. Lord, we thank you for relationships that may have ended. We thank you for various reasons, but we thank you, Lord, for new relationships, for new life in you. And Lord, that is a huge celebration when we see people and we know people are growing in their faith, all because of you. So Lord, help each and every one of us continue that journey, sharing your love, being kind when we just want to rip somebody's head off. Help us to be kind. And Lord, heal. Heal this nation, heal this world. Lots of cray-cray going on. But again, Lord, you go before us and we trust in that. Thank you for families that have traveled a little distance to be here this morning and bring such a joy when you hear there's going to be another three-year-old here. And the teenagers get so excited. So, Lord, we thank you for that as well. Father, many of us are going on different journeys today. Be with each and every person, whether it's moving cattle, baling hay, celebrations of life. Whatever it is, Lord, you know what we're doing. Be with them all. And Lord God, be with this church. And the church is not in this building. The church are the people that are here. So Lord, we pray for each and every one of them and those that couldn't be here as well. Lord, we lift them up to you, asking for your healing and all your power, our superpowers we get from you. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray and we lift up our silent prayers to you. Thank you for loving each and every one of us, knowing the hairs on our head, knew us before we came out of the womb, laid out a plan, beginning to end. Thanks for knowing us that well, God. As we join together for the Lord's Prayer, may you hear and may it be so. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. On earth as it is in heaven, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. All right. Can we just say amen? How can that not put a smile on your face? Love you, buddy. All right, let's stand and worship. We got some oldies, so get ready for some oldies. Amen and amen. Because he loves you.
As you are to us. My voice, for you have heard my
'cause you're worthy. I'll praise you with a dance, and I'll sing glory. Hallelujah. I lift your name on high, and I'll sing holy, 'cause you're worthy. I'll praise you with a dance. I will praise you with a dance. I will praise you with a dance.
So we can have Faith Finders come up, but we just want to share a little story. So that song takes us way, way back. Back to Fish Fusion days when we used to all dance and do our little, you know, jig up front. And Carmen, as many of you know, was up dancing on a pew, and when she stepped down, she actually tore, was it her ACL?
Yeah.
Yeah, she jumped down and tore her ACL during that song. So we, yeah, that was our little fun part from the Methodist church there.
Good morning. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Well, we're going to start out talking a little bit about praising God. It's almost time for Halloween. It's a little ways away, but we're going to be carving pumpkins soon. You're seeing pumpkins for sale everywhere. Do you guys get excited at Halloween? Getting to go out, get candy from people, dressing up? I know I'm definitely getting excited for it. Kids like to get candy. I like to eat candy. So when you get excited, what do you do? How do you express your excitement?
Get happy.
Yep, you can get happy. Maybe do a happy dance. You can sing. Show praise. These are all different things that will help us express praise. So we can do the same thing with God. So God has given us many beautiful blessings. All good things that we have really do come from Him in the end, if you think about it. He wants us to worship Him, give thanks back for all of His gifts. When we praise Him, we show that we rejoice and are happy for His blessings. So I'll share a little story from the Bible. In the Gospel of Luke, there's a story of a time that Mary had visited her cousin Elizabeth. Elizabeth was much older and was pregnant with John the Baptist. After Mary had received the good news that she was going to have baby Jesus, she went to be with Elizabeth for a little while. When Mary came up, Elizabeth felt the baby in her jump for joy. He wasn't even born yet, and he was leaping with delight because he recognized that Jesus was close by. Elizabeth understood that something incredible was happening, and she said a special blessing to Mary for what was happening in her body. In response, Mary sang a special song to God. We call this the Magnificat because she wanted to magnify and glorify God. So in this story, we have a little bit of happy news and joyful reactions. John leaped, Elizabeth shouted, Mary sang, they all gave praise to God and glorified Him for the amazing things He was doing in fulfilling His promises to His people. There are a lot of ways to praise God, and there are many ways we can praise Him too, whether we are singing, dancing, leaping, drawing, speaking, teaching, or whatever we're doing, we can do it for God. We can do it with hearts full of gratitude, joy, and delight in what the Lord has done and continues to do. As we look forward to trick-or-treating, to Halloween, to carving pumpkins, let's remember to give thanks and praise Him every day. God's love to hear our worship and praises. We lift our hearts, voices, and talents to Him and praise Him always with all we are and have. Okay, let's pray. Thank you for sending Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for your many blessings. Please help us to praise you for all that you do and give glory to you as we use our talents for you. Thank you for your love.
Thank you for your love.
We love you, God.
In
Jesus'
name.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, so I brought down some chocolate this time. We'll get you started on trick-or-treating early this year. You can pass this around. You can pick out what you like. What's that? Yep, and then we have another song to sing. Let's stand and worship.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I worship Your holy. Comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord. For my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I worship Your I wish.
am blessed to be able to let you know that B is doing the message today. When he told me what he was going to talk about, I was like, yes. But B, for many of you, he was just a little squirt when I met him many, many years ago. We were down at the Marion Church, of all places, and we went to sing. It was the Blues and, what's it called? Brats and Blues. And this kid is up there playing drums, and we're like, wow, maybe he needs to come to Fish Fusion. So anyway, long story short, that is how we met the Adney family many, many years ago. But we've been through a lot of crazy stuff in life. Calls of, hey, I need you, either way. And so it is my honor to introduce to you Anthony Adney, and he will be giving you the message this morning, and God has put it upon his heart of what he's talking about.
All right. Morning. Let's start out with a quick prayer. Thank you, Lord, for letting us gather here today. We ask that you would open our ears so that we may hear your voice. Open our minds so that we may receive your eternal wisdom. Open our spirits so that we may know your leading and guidance. And open our hearts so that we may receive your wonderful love. We ask this in your glorious name. Amen. All right, so as Renee had said, when I was very young, I was still a teenager, of course, it all started, I used to play in pep band, I used to play percussion, and I had met Renee. We started, we come up and I played with Fish Fusion. At that time, I was not a guy that liked slow songs. Everybody knew it. They always thought I was sleeping in the back. Well, I kind of was. Not going to lie to anybody. I'm in church. Just a little other history of me that some of you may know, some don't. I wasn't supposed to make it to 16. I'm not going to lie to anybody. I had lots of health issues as a kid. And now, look, here I am, 32. I'm talking in front of people I've never, ever thought in a million years I could do. Yes, it's scary, but I got God on my shoulder, helping me. So, no matter what you think your future is going to be, you have no idea. He's got the plan. That's just want to share that. And 32, I don't have really any major health issues. And they pretty much said, if I made it to 16, I was a miracle child. So, just want to share that with everybody that may not have known that. So, what I would like to talk about a little bit is worship. I would like to talk, well, let's see here. When I started with the worship band, as I said, I didn't really know what worship was. At that time, I'd never been introduced to it. I played pep bands, pep rallies, things like that. You didn't think of that as a worship. I played in Fish Fusion with a whole lot of wonderful people. At that time, worship to me meant getting people clapping, getting people dancing. And to do that, a lot of times it was the fast, upbeat, loud, rock-type songs. Well, boy, was I wrong. I figured out after that, even the slow songs that may seem like they bore you, if you listen to them, those are worship songs. Let's see here. I skipped ahead a little bit. So, worship is so many more things than just singing, worshiping the Lord through music. All stuff I really didn't even know till I started looking this up. First off, for you that don't know, let's start out with what worship actually means. Straight out of the dictionary, worship is to honor or show reverence for as a divine being or supernatural power, and to regard with great or extravagant respect, honor, and devotion. So an example of this would be a celebrity having a show, and all the fans afterwards are praising, yelling, screaming, honoring them. Well, same thing in Jesus' world. So let's take a little look at what worship is in the Bible. Worship, more than anything, is a gift of grace and thanksgiving. Jesus just paid the ultimate price for dying for our sins, and therefore gave us peace with God. Worship is not something we do to gain God's favor, or reach a spiritual high, or make us look even more holy, but is actually an act of praising and acknowledging who God is, what He has done for us. Worship can take many different forms. Worship isn't just about singing songs on Sunday, but about so many other things. I was reading through some information, and I found a very good one, that worship is described as a Christian meditation. Christian meditation is unlike the normal secular meditation that we all know about. In the secular meditation, it is described as clearing your mind and going to your happy place out in La La Land, just clearing everything. Christian meditation is very similar. It's about going to a happy place as well, but in a little bit different way. Christian meditation is all about bringing God into our mind, filling our souls with the Holy Spirit and the presence of Him. So with that being said, let's go a little bit deeper. Some different ways we can worship Him, and we don't even realize that we're worshiping Him. We can worship God through prayer. In Philippians 4:6-7, it states, "Don't be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, which surpasses all understanding. Will guide your hearts and your minds in Jesus Christ." So our prayer lives are a great indicator of our reliance on God. Often we feel bad for bringing too many requests to the Lord. At least I do. But with this being said, Jesus tells us to abide in Him and ask for whatever we may need. Prayer is a form of worship because it shows that we believe God has the power to impact our busy, chaotic lives and help us. The more we pray, the more we get to know God's character and trust His power and authority. True worship requires trust. Trust requires reliance. We rely on God by praying and believing that He hears our cries. In all matters of faith and worship, it is very important to start with prayer. Go to the Lord and cry out to Him. Let Him know all of the requests from your heart. There is no such thing as too many requests. To our God, requests are not a burden. He wants to be involved in all of our lives, from the small little parts all the way to the big messed up parts. As you are progressively putting God in His right place as King of the world, this is worshiping and praising Him. So, as we talked about a little before, we can worship God through music. In our crazy busy lives, we may find it hard to make time to worship the Lord our Savior. At least in our house, you wake up, it's chaos, you're running everywhere, you're getting breakfast, you're getting kids in car, you're getting them to school. There's not the time out there, unfortunately. But there is a very simple way to help worship God, even in your busy life. This is worshiping Him through music. A few simple examples of this would be maybe get up 5 minutes earlier in the morning, turn on some Christian radio in the background while you're getting ready, getting your kids ready, getting their breakfast ready. On your commute to work, school, or home, turn on 88.1 in the car. It's a great way to worship Him and not even realize you're doing it. Don't be like Renee, though. She likes to get speeding tickets when she gets going on some of them songs. Be a safe driver, is what I'm trying to say. Now take some time to just listen to the lyrics, understand what they are saying. A lot of times it's not about the music in the background, it's the words that are typed up in the lyrics. Music to me seems to be one of the easiest ways to incorporate worship into our crazy busy lives. When at work, you could possibly put some Christian music on in the background. I know up at the shop we like listen country, but there is days that we'll turn on some Christian music. Just it helps soothe the soul, clear the mind, and make John not want to hurt people. Music is a great way to take some time throughout your day and actually think of the Lord and just put him in your mind. I know he's always in our mind, but he's not really in our mind. We can worship him through singing. In Psalms 33, 1 through 3, it says, "Shout for joy in the Lord, O you righteous. Praise befits the upright. Give thanks to the Lord with the lyre. Make melody to him with the harp of 10 strings. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully on the strings with loud shouts." So worshiping God is a gift to us, but it's also a command from him. When worshiping God through singing, it is very easy for us to get opinionated. We may often find ourselves saying, "That worship was way too loud," or "Those songs were too old," or in my case, "They're too slow, put me to sleep." But we do need to remember that singing, worshiping the Lord, isn't about us and what we like, but about the Lord and what he likes. Worshiping through singing on Sunday morning is a great gift that many of us take for granted. When singing along on Sundays, I encourage you to think a little more about what you are singing and cherish it just a little bit more. Fully contemplate the goodness and glory of the Lord while you do so. With our media platforms, it's so easy these days. We should be able to easily sing and play music any day of the week. God doesn't care for how we sound while we are singing, but rather just that worship music, or that we are worshiping and praising him. An easy time to worship him daily would be turn on worship music when you're getting ready in the morning, when you're taking a shower, getting ready for work. Now your significant others and your kids, they may not like listening to you sing, but it's time for him that we all have. We don't even think about it. This is one time I believe that the Lord trumps your spouse. We can worship him through our work. In Colossians 3, 23 through 24 says, "Whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Christ." So even in God's original plan for humanity, work was included in this. The Lord had given Adam work to do in the Garden of Eden. I'm certain that the balance between work and rest is a little different than what the Lord has intended for us. But this definitely doesn't mean that we can't worship him with our work. An easy way of looking at this is to do everything as if we were doing it for God and not for man or men. Easy ways to worship him at work is to practice having a good attitude, being honest, hardworking, loving your coworkers, and mostly being grateful for the opportunity and the job that God has provided for you. I know this seems like it should be a very easy task, but it definitely isn't. The Lord has grace for us in the times we miss the mark. Just apologize, confess your sin to the Lord. Continue trying day by day to honor God with your work. A lifetime of trying to glorify God with our work will bear good fruit. just remember, we are not doing it to earn God's favor, but in turn doing it in an out of an overflow of our love for Him. We can worship Him through thanksgiving. Something that I'm terrible at, but I definitely need to get better. So with Thanksgiving coming up in a few months, let's just keep that in the back of our mind. On First Thessalonians 5:18 says, "Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you." So during Thanksgiving this year, or maybe even if you're just getting together for supper, for lunch, and you have a prayer before you eat, let's just thank God for what He has given for us. Everything He has given, everything He has helped us with. Show the Lord that you appreciate Him and everything He has done for you. Another great time to thank Him would be during your regular prayers, before bed, in the morning, whatever works into your schedule. We often may forget to thank God for our salvation, for His presence, for His comfort, His word and guidance, and our spiritual growth. Thinking on these things regularly and praising Him for them help us to know Him better and enjoy Him more. We can never thank Him enough and will never run out of things to be thankful for. You can worship the Lord through reading the Bible. When we read the Bible, we learn more about who God is, what He has done, and what that means for us. Growing in our knowledge of the Word helps us to praise God more and more. The Bible leads us to worship God for all that He is. It also instructs us in the ways that our views of God may be faulty, so we can worship Him more fully. Reading the Bible helps lead us to worship, but it is also an act of worship itself. We lay down our view of God and the world and what we think they should be to learn what God Himself actually has to say about these things. When reading the Bible, we have to give our time to the Lord and surrender our own understanding. In turn, this taking time for the Lord and praising Him is worshiping Him. We can worship Him through giving to others. 2 Corinthians 9:7 says, "Each one must give as he has decided in his heart, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver." We worship God when we give to others because it shows that we know the Lord has gifted us with all of our resources that we have. When we give back to others, we are simply giving back to the Lord what is His already. Giving to others helps teach us to be thankful for what we have and helps shape our perspectives to see that all things belong to the Lord and there is nothing we have that wasn't given to us by Him. Lastly, we can worship Him by serving others. Mark 10:44-45 says, "And whoever would be first among you must be slave of all. For even the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give His life as a ransom of many." Just like giving, serving is a great way to be the hands and the feet of the Lord. We can worship God by giving our time, comfort, and gifts to become a servant like our Lord. There are a lot of ways that we can serve. We can volunteer in events that serve our community. You can go on mission trips, spread the word, and serve people there. Volunteer to help with church, as you've seen a few of us stepping up here. Let me tell you, you may think it's tough to do a sermon. It's really not. Once you get going, He's got your back. Volunteer to help with concession stands, or maybe even go visit the nursing home just take time to sit and talk and listen to some of the elderly that may have no one else to talk to. I know I haven't made a dent in all the ways we can worship our Lord and honor Him, but as long as you are taking time for Him, thanking Him, and praising Him, you are worshiping Him. As Renee had talked, we have clipboards we're passing around with concession stands. We need help up there. If anybody has any free time, please help out. It's a good time, and you're worshiping our Lord. In conclusion, I just want to remind everyone we are not trying to gain God's favor, but we are just trying to show praise and thanksgiving for our God, for who God is and what He has done for us. No matter what form of worship you are doing, God loves them all. Let's all stand and worship like we never have before with the closing song. Let's not worry about what we sound like or what we look like. Let's just stand, clap, sing, and worship our good God Almighty. And all the kids can come forwards too. All right, let's close out in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the opportunities and things you have given to each and every one of us. We ask that you help each one of us to worship and praise you just a little bit more. And mostly, help give us a little more balance in our lives that we may have some more time for you. Please be with all of us as we leave here today and protect us and guide us in our busy lives. Please also help keep those spouses from getting really rowdy when we're singing in the bathroom, in the shower. Amen.